if you want to choose the most suitable laser cleaner for your applications, or you have bought the laser cleaner, you want to use it in a better way, I think you need to consider many factors, like the power of the laser, the single pulse energy, the controller, and the type of the cleaning head, and the single pulse energy, many, many things, and reputation of the brand, and how to do the service in your country. So with all these factors, then you choose the most suitable for you. But today, this video, I'm going to focus on how to choose the best laser cleaning head. So before going to really details, we introduce in general. In general, we have two types of cleaning heads. One is for the CW laser, continuous wave, and one for pulse laser cleaner. We can divide in two ways. First, according to the laser. This one is for the continuous wave laser cleaner, for CW laser cleaning gun. And these two are for pulse laser. And in another way, we can divide laser cleaning heads by the number of motors, scanning motors. We have normally this single motor, only one scanner motor for the beam movement. And this one is the, we call it 2D, which means we have two Gablo motors inside this cleaning head. So what's the difference between the single motor and the two motors in the cleaning gun? When we use only one Gablo motor inside the laser cleaning gun, which means that the laser beam, the dots are moved in the way of a line. So normally when you cleaning, you see the surface of the material, many, many lines. So the laser only move in linear way. But in the 2D laser cleaning head, the laser can move in different kind of shapes because they come out as a surface. It's not that the dots move in line, but they can move in a random way. They can go out circular or triangle or square or many other shapes. Like some, they will have 11 or 9 types of the shapes of the movement. And this will have better cleaning effects, but they also have defects. They cannot cleaning, they can only do job in a flat surface. If you go like a little bit shaped or round or inside the pipes, tubes, which are not very suitable. And there is no pure good or better, bad or good way of choosing single motor or double motor. It only depends on the cleaning effects you want. Then we come to the size and the weight of the laser cleaning gun. Normally, customer always want as small as possible because most of you are doing handheld laser cleaning service. So how to make the laser cleaning guns as smaller as possible? The laser cleaning gun need to connect with the laser. And the connector, the size of the connector decide how the size of the cleaning gun. For the power less than, average power less than 300 watts, most of the laser manufacturers choose QCS or isolator. These two type of connector, and QCS is very small, so mostly we choose QCS connector, and even different brand of lasers, they have different size of QCS connector. We normally tend to choose the smallest one so as to make smaller size of the cleaning gun. But for power more than 300 watt, like 500, 1 kilowatt pulse laser, they normally goes to isolator, or even they will have QBH connector. From the laser to the cleaning gun, we come to the beam pass. In the beam pass also decides the size of laser cleaning gun, especially the size of the lens on the Gablo meter, because the beam pass goes like Laser come out from the laser, from this connector, and then from collimator to make the beam in a linear way. And then is the focus, then is the X-axis motor and Y-axis motor, this is 2D. And then field length, which then come out to the surface of the material. So all these beam paths, we need mirrors, lenses, especially the motor, because laser need to be reflected from the X-axis to the Y-axis. So the length, the size, how to choose it, depends on the size of the beam. For example, like this laser from IPG, we have the beam spot size 6 to 8 millimeter. So we have to choose at least 9 or 10 millimeter as the mirrors, reflective mirrors on the galvanized motor. Then the mirror has a weight. The galvanometer has to carry the mirror to move in a very rapid speed. So you need to, then you choose the model of the motor. Then you need to give the space for this motor. So this forms that how you design the laser cleaning gun. You have to, you know, you have the model, size, weight of this, everything, and then you probably come out with the drawing of the laser cleaning gun. Of course, everybody wants to make it as small as possible, but you have to give the stability and the performance of all these parts. So in that way, we know that smaller of the beam and the smaller of the mirror and the smaller of your cleaning gun. But if it's real that is the cleaning gun is as small as better? No. So we can see from the difference of using a 3 millimeter beam and a 6 millimeter beam to cleaning, you will get different cleaning speed and cleaning quality. So when we choose a laser cleaning gun, of course, if it's smaller, it's very friendly or is good for the operator workload. But another factor is that we must consider is the cleaning quality. Because we do this job, we want to clean it. We want to clean it in a fast way. And this is, we must guarantee. So based on all the factors, we first need to satisfy your cleaning requirements, which means the quality and speed. And then based on this, we make as small as possible of your cleaning gun. Then about the cleaning shapes. Now I told that for 2D laser cleaning gun, which means you have two motors, you can have 2D shapes like circles or squares or triangle or many other shapes. So many customers will ask that, what's the function of these different shapes for the cleaning quality? I have to say sometimes it's useful, especially for a flat and very thin surface, and you won't get equal quality, or it looks really no hurt for the base material, and this is softer 2D way. So, but even if you use the same laser, same 2D scanners, and you came with the same shapes around circle, you actually get different cleaning quality. We can see from this video. So this doesn't mean that linear is bad or 2D is good, or if you have many fancy shapes, your cleaning machine is more powerful. No, this doesn't relate it anyway. It still depend on, even you do the same circle, but the photons or the beam is moving with different hologram or different software, the calculation, and then you got different cleaning quality. We are now launching a new product. It's a no hurt for the base material laser cleaner pathway for 200 watt. Because in some occasions, like you cleaning for the stainless steel especially, because stainless steel, when you handheld the cleaning gun, the focus is not fixed because you probably move. You cannot hold it all the time. And then focus is move up and down. So the stainless steel is very easily to get oxidate or become yellow, or the cleaning quality is not equal because it's very sensitive for the to the beam, to the energy, for the heat effect. So, but with our new model of this no hurt for the base material, especially for stainless steel, we choose a very special laser and very special way of the beam movement. And then even if you move the cleaning gun a little bit, and sometimes you stay longer at one point and you faster in another point, but you get very equal cleaning quality. This is very popular and needed for many stainless steel after welding or before welding or this kind of scenarios. Last point is the stability of the laser cleaning gun. So no matter how small you make it and how fancy you make it and how fast, how good the quality is, but it needs to work day and night for a long time. So stability comes from three factors. First, the most important is sealed, completely sealed. Because when you're cleaning, it's a lot of smoke, dust, because you vaporize the surface, the pollution occasion. And then all the dust, smoke will come back to the beam path. So this, how good you sealed the whole beam path, no dust to come back, and then all the optics inside can use last longer. So this is the first important point, and it only can be tested by how many cases, I mean, how many installations, how many units you sold. And this experience, upgradation, and always new models, improvements make a better products. And second is the cooling, because when you use laser cleaning, no matter 200 watt or especially when you go high power, 500 watt, 1 kilowatt, there is big heat pressure for all the optics inside, for the focus lens, reflective lens. So you need to cooling down all these optics. Normally we have air cooling and water cooling. For power less than 300 watt, we can use air cooling. All the model of DMK laser cleaners, power less than 300 watt, we have the interface, the inlet of cooling air inside. You can use it if you have very long duration work. Or you can not use it if you break like 200 watt or 100 watt and you don't work really very long time. And water cooling for 500 watt and 1 kilowatt is needed. And even for multi-mode 300 watt, we also have water cooled model. It can be more stable for long lasting work. But even everybody will tell you that they have a chiller for the cooling of the laser. But for the cleaning gun, the cooling effects will much depend on how you manufacture the micro cooling channels inside the laser cleaning gun, because it's very small and compact and you use very light materials, and you need to consider the sealing, and you need to consider the precision on moving the optics, and also you need to consider the cooling effects of these optics. Then it becomes not an easy job. It's experience and the way that how you creative and you the engineer experience, many things. And the third is the stability of the optics, because all this beam passing through all kinds of lenses and optics, the coating quality and especially the duration of the beam past all these lenses. So these optics, especially it's difficult when you go high power, because you always want to use a smaller lens to do this, you know, the percentage of passing through of the beam and the coating quality, the reflective lens also. These are depends on you always looking for the best supplier of these optics and choose the best material, the best coating procedure, and the way they process these lenses, and how much we test it and how many hours we have been using this. We DMK has been also a supply for all kinds, not only laser cleaning but laser welding, laser cutting, super high power. We kind of very deep involved in optics supply chain from China, so we are very confident of the stability of our laser cleaning. Okay, so after all this, I've introduced every single technical point on how to design and how to choose the best laser cleaning gun for a laser cleaning machine. Our design engineer and service engineers also prepared a full list of the most common problems of laser cleaning gun during your application, how to diagnose, how to solve these problems if your laser cleaning gun has issues. If you need it, you can email to me or send me message on my WhatsApp number. Please subscribe to JallyTalk channel and I will give you this list. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye. On the champion.